This call is now being recorded.
Okay, very good morning students. So today's topic is binary search tree. Okay, so today we are going to discuss about just basic operations of your binary search tree. What is the purpose of a binary search tree and what is the speciality of a binary search tree? How it is different from the binary tree? Okay, so till last class we discussed about binary tree, different types of binary tree, expressions tree, okay, isn't it? And construction of expression tree, implementations of all those things, etc. So today it's a very interesting topic and it is a very important concept. Okay, if you see many that is searching, if you want to search any particular data, this algorithm is used over there. Okay, so I want you people to understand this concept, so please listen carefully. This is a very interesting and easy topic. Okay, and first one is, let's see what do you mean by binary search tree. Why we call it as a search is included in your binary tree. Okay, so as the name says, a binary search tree, it is a part of your binary tree. Okay, it comes from only the binary tree. So binary tree means, what is the rule you have to follow? Binary tree, at most, okay, maximum you can have only two branches. Okay, so in the binary search tree also, it also follows the same rule. Here also, maximum you can have only the two children. Then what makes the difference means, in binary tree, that is, if you want to add any elements, means wherever you want to add the elements, you can add that elements in your tree. Suppose if you have a root element, if the spaces are there, means then I can insert the elements in your tree. But in the case of a binary search tree, I should follow the two rules should be followed over here. Let's see what are the two rules should be followed. So in your binary search tree, so you have to remember these two rules. That is the, I think you know what you may left subtree and what you may right subtree, isn't it? So always you remember this, left subtree should be less than that of your parent node. Okay, that is, if you have a left subtree, if you take any particular root or parent node, means all the elements which is present in your left side or left subtree of that particular root node should be less than that of your parent node. Similarly, for your what is the condition for your right subtree, means that should be greater than or equal to that of your parent node. Okay, so these are the two conditions you have to follow for your binary search tree. Okay, I will explain later why we call it as a search tree. So first you understand why, what you mean by binary search tree. So these two properties, these two rules should be followed while constructing your binary search tree. Okay, so what are the two rules? Means all the elements which is present in your left subtree should be less than that of your root. Okay, similarly, all the elements which is present in your right subtree should be greater than that of your root. Example, let us consider for this one. Okay, so for this root node, let us consider this is your root node, isn't it? For this root node, this is your, this part belongs to your left subtree. Can you follow? So these are the elements which is there in your left subtree. If you see the values in your left subtree, that is 10, 14, 19, all the elements will be less than that of your root element 27, isn't it? Similarly, if you see on your right side, okay, so right subtree is nothing but 35, 31, 42. So all these elements will be greater than that of your root element 27. So this is the rule you have to follow for each and every node, not only this parent, that is a root node. Say suppose if you see this 14, okay, let us consider for this 14, what happens here, let us see. Okay, so for this 14, what happens, this 10 is the left subtree or left child of this one, isn't it? So this is less than that of your root node for 14. Similarly, this 19, what happens, 19 is greater than that of year 14. So for each and every node, you have to ensure that it satisfies the binary search tree property. Similarly, for this side, okay, other side. So here 31 is less than that of year 35. Similarly, this 42 is greater than that of year this one. Okay. So this you have to follow in your binary search tree. In your binary search tree, what is the rule you have to follow? Left side should be the less element and right side should be the greater element. So that should be followed in your binary search tree. So if you see this left subtree, all the elements are less than that of your root element. So that is the root element will be the greater than that of your this one. Similarly, for this one, what happens? So this root will be, that is the root element will be less than that of your right side element. So you have to follow these rules. Okay. So next, let us see the exact concept. Let us consider this diagram. Okay. So for this, root is nothing but 11. Okay. So let us consider for this one, all the elements which is present in your left subtree. These are the elements which is present in your left subtree. What are the elements which is present in your left subtree of 11? 7, 5, 8, 9, 10, isn't it? If you see this one, all the elements will be less than that of your parent node, that is 11, isn't it? So you have to ensure that your left subtree element should be less than that of your parent node, that is a root node 11. Similarly, if I take the right subtree elements, okay? So for your right subtree elements, what are the right subtree elements? These are the right subtree elements. So that is 12, 4, 13, okay? So here what happens, let us consider this is 14. Let us consider some 11, okay, something like this. Okay, so you have to ensure that all the elements should be greater than that of your binary search tree. So you have to ensure this one, okay? So next one, let us see what is the difference between your binary tree and binary search tree. Why you have to go for your binary search tree rather than that of your binary tree? Okay, what is the purpose of your binary search tree? As the name indicate, it is mainly used for your searching purpose. Okay, suppose if you have let us consider 1,000 or 1,00,000 of records are stored in your database, means if you want to have a quick search, okay, if you are searching some particular data, it should be searched quickly, means in that case you have to go for your binary search tree. Let's see the two examples. Suppose if you want to search particular data, how it works for the binary tree and how it works for the binary search tree. Okay, so let us take an example. If I want to search this particular element, for let us consider this example. Okay, I want to search this element, that is 4 is present in the database or not. So according to this binary tree, how I will do searching means I go for a traversal. Okay, so I have three options. One is an in-order traversal, pre-order traversal, post-order traversal, or otherwise I can go for a level order traversal. Okay, so I can use any type of techniques to search particular node. Okay, let us consider I go for a level order traversal something, because I cannot do searching in your comparison. Okay, because the elements are inserted wherever you want, you can insert the elements if the spaces are there. Okay, so that is the rule which is followed in your binary tree. So if I want to search for means, so what I will do means, so first my pointer is in root. Always you all know that whenever you do any traversal, or if you want to do any searching purpose or insertion purpose, your pointer will be at the root node, isn't it? So I am in the root node. Say suppose if I want to know whether the element is present in the binary tree, means so let me assume that I go for a in-order traversal. Okay, let us assume in this way. So from this, what I will do, I will go for your this particular node. Okay, so next one I will go for the comparison. This 7 is, let us consider the searching element is 4. Okay, and it will compare with the root element, so it is not satisfied, so it enters into the left subtree again. It will not satisfied. So what happens again is enter into the left subtree and it compare with the 2 and 7, it will not satisfy. So once this left side part is over means what I will do, I will go to the parent node of this 7. So I start searching from this side, isn't it? So again I will compare the 6 with the 4, it will not satisfy. Then it will go for your this left side, so it will not satisfy. Then go for your right side, okay, it will compare this 11 and 4. So it will not satisfy. When the left side is over means I travel along your right side. So again it will start comparing with your 5 and 4. It will not satisfy. Next one is 9 and 4. Okay, it will not satisfy. Then after this one it comes into a 4. Now it will compare this 4 and 4. It is satisfied. Now after doing this many comparison only, finally I reach this particular node. So how many nodes it traveled means, so almost 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 comparison. So in order to search this particular element is present or not in this particular mind, in this particular binary tree, I made 9 comparisons, isn't it? So it that is a totally have only the let us consider I have only the 9 nodes. Okay, maximum have only the 9 nodes in your binary tree. So for the worst case, what happens? I have to go for a 9 comparison, okay, in order to perceive a particular elements is present or not for your worst case. Okay, suppose if you have a 9 nodes means for a worst case, I have to go for a n comparisons. Okay, so that is your that it may takes more time to do this process. Let's see what happens over here when I use. Let us consider I have the same 9 elements is present in your binary search tree, okay, and the same position I'm going to take. I have to see that whether this particular element 13 is present in your node or not. In this case, what I will do, so I start doing comparison from your binary search tree. Okay, so what happens means you all know that the elements which is present in your left subtree should be less than that of your root node. Similarly, the elements which is present in your right subtree should be greater than that of your root node. Okay, and let us consider searching element is 13. So this is the element to be searched. Okay, so what happens now? So from this root node, it will do that is a comparison whether it is greater or less than. So now what happens? Root element is less than that of your 13, isn't it? So what it will do means, so if it is that is a root element is less than means, so what now what happens means definitely that particular searching element will be present only on the right subtree, isn't it? Suppose a search element is less means then I go for your left subtree, but here what happens that the element searching element is greater than that of your root element. So what happens, obviously that element is will be present only in the right subtree. So I go for your right side and I will omit all these elements. Okay, I will not go and see whether the element 13 is present here or not. Okay, this comparison process I will not do. Can you follow this one? Because the 13 is greater than that of your root elements, so therefore I will travel only on the right subtree, not your left subtree. Okay, so now here what happens, again I go for your right side. So here I will do comparison with this particular root element, that is 10. So again here what happens, this root element is less than that of your 13. If it is less means obviously I have to go for your right subtree, isn't it? So right subtree again this the comparison goes. So here what happens, again the I'm going to compare with your root element 14 and 13. So now here 14 is greater, that is the root element is greater than that of your 13. So search element is less means then I have to go for your left subtree. So next one I'm going to do searching for this one. So what happens, here's element is formed. See here how many nodes I have visited. So I have compared 1 2 3, 4. Okay, among these 9 elements, I visited one. That is, I made a comparison between only the four rules. But here, what happens for the worst case also, I made the comparison, 9 comparison I have done. So this is how the binary search tree works. And for searching purpose, I go for a binary search tree rather than that of your binary tree. That is for a quick and easy searching purpose. I'm going to use the binary search tree. Yes, can you follow? Yes, students. Is it okay, ma'am?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, is it clear? Okay. Okay, next one, let's see why we go for a binary search tree. As we discussed in our previous slide, in order to speed, okay, in order to go for a searching in a speed manner, okay, we go for a binary search tree. Basically, that is, if you have a key value, okay, and with the key value, if you want to go for any comparison, that is a left subtree, right subtree comparison, means in this case, you'll be using a binary search tree. And for your gains, when your searching goes into a very speed of manner, means then you can utilize this type of techniques in the graphics and other gaming technologies. You can use this binary search tree techniques, okay? And it supports basic operations like searching, insertion, and deletion. So all these operations will be more efficient than that of other algorithms like binary tree algorithms. Okay, so that's why we go for your binary search tree technique. Okay, can you follow this one? It means that in a speedly we can search particular element, and if I want to insert any particular element also, I can easily insert the element. And if I want to do if I want to delete any element also, if searching process is easy, means easily I can remove the particular element, isn't it? So that's why I go for binary search tree rather than that of your binary tree or any other tree. Okay, and let's see what are the basic operations in your binary search tree. Basically, you'll have three operations. Okay, so what are the operations? Means searching operations, insertion operation, and deletion operations. I think you know what do we mean by searching. Searching means if I want to know, see that whether particular element is present or not, means, okay, already we discussed in our previous slide, isn't it? So if you want to see whether the particular element is present in your tree or not, means that operation we call it as a searching operation. Next one, insertion. Inserting means if I want to insert particular element in your binary tree, we call it as an insertion operation. And deletion means if I want to remove, if I want to take some element from your binary tree, I call it as a deletion operation. Now we are going to discuss all these operations in detail. Okay. And first one is a search operation. So let us have one this example. Okay, already I explained this searching operation. Once again, let us see this searching operation over here. Let us assume that, so this is the binary search tree, okay, that is there in your database, okay. So you have stored your elements in your, that is by using this binary search tree algorithm, you have stored your elements in your database. Let us see how this searching operation works, okay. And let us consider this 10 elements. You have to see that whether the particular 10 element is present in your binary search tree or not. So what you have to do means you should start searching from your root node, isn't it? So you are going to start searching from your root node 12. What is the root node? Root node is 12 and searching element is 10. This is your searching element. Now you have to do the comparison between your 12 and 10. So now what happens? This 12 root element is greater than that of your searching element. If your root element is greater, means it means that definitely the searching element will be present only on the left side. So you have to search only for your left side, that is a left subtree of your root element, because this 10 is less than that of your root element 2. So now what I'm going to do means, so I'm going to perform a, I'm going to see whether that element is present in your left subtree or not. So from this 12, I'm going to travel along your left subtree. So in your left side, I have the element 7. Now my current root is nothing but 7. Okay. So now I have to compare my 10 is greater than 7 or not. Okay. So I have to do comparison. Whether the I have to count while I'm comparing, what happens? 10 is greater than 7. If my searching element is greater than the root element means, then what I have to do? I have to go for your right subtree. Okay. If it is less than means, then I have to go for your left subtree. But here what happened? The searching element is greater than that of your root element. Therefore, I am going to search for, go for your right subtree. So in this case, I have to go for your right subtree. So for this case, what happens means, again, I go for a comparison. So 9, okay, now I have a 9, okay. So for this 9, I have to go for a comparison whether the element is present or not, okay. So now what happens? So this 10 is greater than that of your 9. So if it is greater than that of your root element means I go for your right subtree searching. So here what happens, the 10 you have and you have to compare your searching element 10 with this side. Okay, now what happens, it is equal to that of your root elements. So match occurs. So you can say that the particular element is present. Okay, say suppose when you reach your last level, okay, and you see that particular element is not present means, then you have to come into conclude that you have to say that particular element is not present. Say suppose instead of 10, if I want to search this 11 means, definitely this one will be your last level, that is the last node, isn't it? Say suppose when I do a binary search tree, that is why when I do a searching technique for this one, suppose if after doing the comparison, I don't have that element means, then I have to say that the element is it's not present in your binary search tree. So this is how you have to perform a searching techniques for your binary search tree. Yes, is it okay? Can you follow?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, any doubt in this, ma'am? So always you remember that all the elements which is present in your left subtree should be less than that of your root, and the elements which is present in your right subtree should be greater than that of your root. Okay, so next one, let us see for your insertion operations. Okay, so you forgot about this one, this diagram. Let us take this one, these elements. Can you see these elements? Okay, so what are the elements means? You have 12, 7, 9, 19, 5 and 10. Okay. You please take these elements in your notebook. Now let us do insertion operations. Okay. Let us assume that you are going to construct a binary search tree. Okay. Suppose if you have these elements means, let us see how you are going to construct a binary search tree. So first one, what I'm going to do, what you have to do means, first, what is the first element in this these numbers means, first element is 12. Okay, you have to see from left to right. Okay, so what is the first element? First element is 12. So if it is 12 means you have to make this 12 as your root element. Okay, you have to mark this one as a root element. Okay, next, what is the next element? Next element is 7. Can you see this one? So next element is 7. So now you have to see that next element is 7. So 7 means you have constructed only one element, isn't it? Now I have to insert the element 7. So where I will insert the 7? So you have to compare the 7 and 12. Okay. So when you compare this 7 and 12, 7 is less than that of your 12. So you know that when the elements is less than that of your root means, you have to place it on the left side, isn't it? So what I'm going to do means, so definitely that 7 should be placed on your left side of your root element 12. So this is how you have to insert your element. Okay, so next one, what is the next element? So next element is 9. So always you remember, you, if you want to do an insertion, you have to do it from your starting node, okay? So you do it from your that is you have to do it from your this root element, and you have to perform a comparison. So nine, if nine is, so now I have to insert the element nine. So where will I insert means, so definitely when I compare this 12 and 9, 9 is less than that of your root element 12. So I go for your which side means I go for a left side. So now this is my current node. I have to compare the 9 with this element root node 7. So obviously 9 is greater than that of your 7. So what I have to do means I have to create a element that is your node for your right side, okay, and I have to insert the 9 element over here, okay. Suppose if it is if you have a space means, then you can create a node and you can insert that element. Suppose if you don't have your space means, then you have to go for a comparison. So next one is 19. If you see this 19, what happens, you have to compare with 19 and 12, okay. Now this inserting element is 19. So now what happens, this 19 is greater than that of this 19 is greater than that of your 12, isn't it? So what I have to do, definitely I have to insert only on the right side of your root, because this 19 is greater than that of your 12. If the inserting element is greater than that of your root element means, definitely that should be placed on your right side. So you have to create a node and insert this 19 over there, okay. So next one, what is the next element? So next element is nothing but your, what is the next element, anyone? So after inserting 19, what is the next element?
Five.
Yes, 5 is your next element. So where will you place this 5? So again you have to start searching from your root element, okay. So 5, so 5 is, you know, here what happens, you compare this 5 and 12, it is less, okay. If it is less means I have to traverse along your left subtree, isn't it? Now I'm here, so now what I have to do, now I have to compare this 5 and this root element 7. So here what happens, while doing the comparison, 5 is less than that of your 7. So here what happens, I have to see that whether the left side is vacant or not. Definitely 7 of left child is null, isn't it? I don't have any branches. Therefore, I'm going to create the branches over here and I'm going to insert the element 5. Okay, so this is how you have to insert the 5. And the last element is 10. Okay, so now I have to insert the element 10. So again, I do start searching from your root element in order to insert the element 10, okay? So what I'm going to do means, first one, I have to compare with the 10 with your root element, that is 12. So definitely it is less than that of your 12. So I'm going to do searching with your left side, okay? So I have to travel along your left side. So when I do the comparison with your 10 and 7, what happens? 10 is greater than that of your 7. So I have to go for a right side. So when I go for a right side, this is my searching, that this is my comparison element. 9 is a comparison element. Now I have to compare this 10 with your 9. So when I compare this 10 with your 9, what happens? 10 is greater than that of your 9. So I'm going to create a node on your right side and I'm going to insert the 10 over here. Okay, so this is the binary search tree. So now see here, the elements, all the elements which is present in your left subtree will be greater, left subtree will be less than that of your root node, and the elements which is present on your right subtree will be greater than that of your root node, okay. So the left subtree should be less than that of your root node and the right subtree should be greater than that of your root node. If you see each and every node, it satisfies the condition. So if you see this 9 and 10, it is greater than that of the root element 7. Similarly, if you see this 5, it is less than that of the parent node 7. So it should satisfy this condition. So insertion operation works like this, okay. Say suppose if I want to insert the element, let us assume that I want to insert the element 6, okay. I need the answer from this, from you all. So if I want to insert the element 6, means where will I insert this element 6? So next to 1 is, so I want to insert the element 6. 6 is the insertion, that is new element to be inserted. Let us assume that this is the binary search tree already, it is existing, okay, in your database. In that one, I have to insert the element 6. So where will I insert the element 6? Any answer?
The right side of 5, ma'am.
Yes, right side of your 5. It's a right answer, okay? So I'm going to insert the right child of your 5. It's good, ma'am. So here I'm going to insert the element. Can you follow this one? Suppose if I want to insert next element, if I want to insert 15. 15 is my insertion element. I want answer from the boys' side. Always girls are answering. Anyone from the boys' side? So if I want to insert the element 15, where will I insert, ma? Boys? Yes? Boys, can you follow this binary search tree? So if I want to insert the element 15, anyone from boys' side? Yes? No answer, huh? At least you put it in a chat, ma. So where will I insert this element 15 in your binary search tree? Students, are you listening? Yes? Otherwise, I'm going to call up the name. Venkata Ramanan, after 12, okay, after 12, where I will insert 15, after 12 means, yes, you are going to insert left child, as a left child of your 19th node, okay, what about others? Asha, answer is correct. What about others? Getting this answer. So how will I insert this element 15? So I stood sharp searching from your root node, that is 12. Okay, it is, that is 15 is greater, therefore I have to travel along your right side. So now I have to compare my 15 element with your 19, because 19 is my current node. If it is less, means I have to insert your 15 over here. Okay, so in this part you are going to insert it. Can you follow this one? Yes? Yes, students, can you follow, ma? Any doubt?
Yes, ma'am.
Shall I proceed?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Is it okay, ma? If this is okay, only you can understand your deletion operations or any other operations. If your binary search tree insertion operation is, can you follow this one? What about others? Are you listening, boys? Yes, Mano. Are you there, Mano? Mano, Lakshmanan. Mani, answer pannala. I'm going to mark it as absent. Kishore Kumar. Are you there, Kishore Kumar? Yes, Lokdeep. Okay. So this happens in your insertion operations. Okay. So let's see what happens in your deletion operation. So when you want to perform a deletion operation, means, so you have to see that where this particular node exists. What do you mean deletion operation? So what do you mean deletion operation? You have to remove a particular element from your binary search tree, isn't it? That we call it as a deletion operation. Let's see what happens in your deletion operation. Yes, students, can you follow this binary search tree? Is it okay? Or do you want me to repeat any concept? Is it clear, ma? Please respond me. Only
yes,
girls
ma'am.
Are answering. I think only girls are answering. What about boys, ma? Huh? Kannan. So, I didn't see any boys' names over here. So, okay, let me see the deletion operations. So, ready to see the deletion operation? If you are clear in insertion operation only, it will be easy for you to see the deletion operation. Easily you can understand the deletion operation, okay? So, let me explain the deletion operation. Let us see only one single example today, okay? Next class, I will explain the other cases, okay? So, when I go for a deletion operations, you will have three cases, okay? So, delete means what? Removing an element from a, that is, removing a node from a particular tree. We call it as a deletion, isn't it? So, here you will have a three cases. Let us see what are the three cases. So, case one, what happens means you are going to delete the node which contains no children. It means that this is the leaf node. If it is a leaf node, means then how you are going to delete the leaf node? So, this is the case number one. Okay, this is, let us consider this is for the first option or first case. So, if it is a leaf node, means then how we are going to, what is the procedure you have to follow to delete the node? Okay. So, next one, second case means, suppose if you want to delete a node, but that node contains only one child, means then what you have to do? Okay. So, that is your second case. So, third case means, so if you are going to delete a particular node and that node contains two children. If you have two children, then what is the procedure you have to follow? So, for this, that is your third case. So, first case means deleted node contains no branches or it is a leaf node. Okay, then what is the thing you have to do? Next one, second case, suppose if the deleted node contains only one child, then what is the procedure? And third case is if it contains two children, then what you have to do? So, let's see only for a first case. Suppose if it is a deleting node contains a no child, okay? So, let us consider this tree. Can you see this tree? So, let us consider this tree. So, this tree contains This tree, in this tree, what I'm going to do means, I'm going to delete a node 19, okay? So, if I want to delete the node 19, it means that I have to delete the link also. That is a connection between 12 and 19, okay? Let's see before deletion, after deletion, what happens? So, this is a before deletion tree and this is a after deletion tree. So, how we are going to delete means, so what you have to do? So, first one, this 19 node to be deleted. So, first you have to see that where this 19 node exists. So, 19 node exists on the right child of your 12. Isn't it? It is present in your right child of your 12. And if you see this 19, see here, you don't have any children. Do you have any children? So, you don't have any children. Therefore, what I'm going to do means it's very easy to delete. So, how you can remove this link means just, so before deletion, what happens? The address of this 19 is marked in the right child of your 12 node, isn't it? So, how these two nodes are linked to each other, the right child of your 12, you will have the address of 19. Say, suppose the address is some 500 means. So, in your address of right child of your 12, you will have a 500, isn't it? So, 500 will be present over here. So, if you want to remove this one, what I'm going to do, instead of filling this 500, I'm going to mark it as a null. It means that, so after this 12, I don't have any other right child. Okay, so this is how I am going to delete the element on your right child of, that is your node contains the only, that is a node children. Okay, so simply I am going to delete the 19 node, because so when I do traversal, what happens? So when I 12 of right is what happens, null. So if it is null, means it means that I don't have any other node which is present in your right side. So in this way I have deleted the that is a node which contains the no children. Can you follow this one, ma'am? Say suppose if I want to delete this 10. Okay, so this particular node 10, if I want to delete, means then what will I do? So it means that I have to remove the link between 9 and 10, isn't it? So if I want to remove this 10, means I should detach the that is a 10 from the node 9, that is from your binary search tree. If I want to remove this old part, what I have to do, simply I'm going to mark the 9 of right child. Okay, so right child, let us consider, before removing I may have the address of this 10 node will be stored over here. Let us consider the address of 10 is some 700, isn't it? So 700 is stored over here, 9 of right is 700 is placed over here. Suppose if you want to remove this 10, what I have to do, I have to mark this one as, so I have to mark this one as null, isn't it? So instead of 500, I am going to put the null over here. If I put this null, what happens? This 10 is deleted. Automatically, I am going to detach this 10 from your this 9. So this is how the node to be deleted, that is deleted node contains a no children, easily you can remove in this way. Okay, so within this, let us stop this session. So if you have any doubt, yes, any doubt? Students, if you have any doubt, please ask me. No doubt. What about others? Yes, is it clear, ma'am? Binary search tree? Can you follow this binary search tree? Oh, no doubts. Okay, thank you, students. So please work these binary search tree problems. You take some examples and try to construct your binary search tree, okay, so that you can easily follow in our next class. Okay,